I don't know why the other day I was thinking, man, how come I haven't told you guys about the dumbest story in my life where I just made an ass out of myself with Bugatti, with a friend of mine, with a friend of mine that owns a car dealership. I mean, with everyone. And of course, I want to take you back to 3 years ago when I was at the older house and I was getting ready to make a baking baked episode. I remember perfectly, I was in the kitchen, I was getting everything ready, and all of a sudden I get a call from my friend in New York, and he owns a dealership. He goes, Alejandro? I'm like, yes. He goes, you're never gonna believe this. I remember you told me that there's a Bugatti that is gonna come out that you're really excited about, the special edition one, and I go, oh my God, here it is. It's that Bugatti Le Mans car that they're only gonna make 12 or 7 of them, and they're gonna be super expensive. This is the one. That's the car that I've been waiting for. That's the car that I think is gonna be super special, because let's face it, Bugatti does something really special with their cars, and especially the really special edition ones, like the world record ones and those. So I was like, this is it. This is it, homie. Don't fucking sleep on this. I'm like, all right. And he goes, I think you know what car I'm talking about. So I go immediately, of course I know what car you're talking about, man. I'm a fucking car expert according to YouTube, so I know what you're talking about. And he goes, okay, so if you wanna buy it, you gotta let me know now. And I'm like, I wanna buy it. I wanna buy it. Don't ever say no, no matter what, and you'll see what I'm talking about right now. So I was like, I wanna buy it, count me in, put me on the list, let's go. And he goes, perfect. And I go, what do I need to do now? And he goes, well, the car's gonna cost anywhere between 5 and 6 million, which was immediately like, oh, well, it is a really rare Bugatti. So if it's 5 and 6 million, the first thing I need to do is obviously call a friend and see if they wanna buy the car with me, because I don't have $5 to $6 million to spend in one car. That's fucking ridiculous. Who the fuck does that? Like, there's very few people in the world that can do that. You know, not one of those. So I was like, all right, I need to call a friend and see if he wants to buy the car with me. And then he goes, you gotta come to New York, check out the car, talk to Bugatti, the actual people from Bugatti, spec your car, and then once you place your order, put the deposit, and then the car's yours. I was like, all right, then count me in. Let's go to New York. So I get on a plane, I'm all excited. Even the morning before going to check out the car, I remember that I was so excited that I wanted to go and walk around the city and just take it all in, because that's the day. I'm buying the daddy of all Bugattis, right? Like, you gotta take it all in. That's what she said. So as we're walking in, I remember getting to the building, and actually before that, I had to call a friend of mine that had told me he doesn't have a lot of great cars. He's got one or two like crazy cars, but nothing else. So he's not on anybody's list. He's one of those guys that no one knows his name or one of those things. And he had told me, if you ever want to buy a crazy car, let me know. I'll buy some cars with you. So I was like, man, I'm going to call this guy. So I called my friend and I'm like, hey, dude, listen, I got an opportunity to buy that crazy Bugatti that I was telling you about like a while ago. And he goes, no way. I'm like, yeah. And he goes, how much is it going to be? And I'm like, $5 to $6 million. And I'm all nervous about this, right? Because $5 to $6 million is a fucking lot of money. And my friend goes, that's it? $5 to $6 million? Yeah, I'm in. Consider it done. Whatever you need, just let me know. I was like, that's it. We're getting a fucking new Bugatti. We're getting a new Bugatti. So this is the day, man. I'm in New York City. I'm already walking around. I'm at the building. I'm at the address. And I remember reading the full address once I got there. And I go, this is on the 10th floor. How the fuck did those guys fucking put a car up there? And I go, you know what? That's Bugatti, man. That's Bugatti. They have so much money. They probably teleported the car. They opened the building in half. Whatever the fuck they needed to do, they did it. Because that's Bugatti. The car that I'm about to buy costs between $5 and $6 million. Of course they stuffed in the car right there. So I was really excited to see it, but that was the first like, what's gonna happen? So we get upstairs, we get to the Bugatti suite, open the door, and the first thing I see is Stefan Winkelmann. And I don't know if you guys know who that is. That's the CEO of Bugatti, and he used to be the CEO of Lamborghini. He's the CEO that I used to make fun of all the time in my videos. I made a video called Lamborghini CEO or something. We're spending a day with the Lamborghini CEO. So I made a lot of parodies about him.
Hey, shut up. You're a small Lamborghini. You get no respect in the family.
Oh no, I need the respect of the family. I am super fast.
Shut up, you don't have a V12.
And I was like, oh fuck, this is gonna go terribly. He's gonna be like, get the fuck out of here, leave immediately. That was my first thought. So when I saw him, I was like, and he's like, hi, I'm Stefan Winkelmann. And I was like, oh my God, he has no fucking idea who I am. Of course, why would he know? That's awesome. So I walk in, I'm like, all right, dodging bullets, baby, we're in. So we get into the place, and immediately I see all the people that work with Bugatti, but I've never seen before. You normally get to see like the people that work underneath Stefan and all of those guys. I know them, like Maurice and all the other guys. But there's two or three other people that I've never seen in my life before. And I thought, you know, it's the PR marketing department or something like that. Like, it's normal, it's not a big deal. But it's a small apartment. Let me go back to that. It's a really tiny fucking place. Which, again, I was like, it's not a big deal. They're gonna open a door, the car's gonna be right there. So all of a sudden, one of those people come over and he's wearing his Bugatti thing and he's German accent. And he goes, hey man, do you want to buy a bike with your car? I'm like, a bike? And he goes, a Bugatti bike. So I thought he was talking about like, man, he's maybe a motorcycle or something. And all of a sudden he brings this bicycle in front of me and I go, oh, that's kind of cute. That's a fucking Bugatti bicycle. That's cool. Like, that's cool. I would actually probably buy that. You know what? Why not? I'm buying a fucking $5 to $6 million car. I'll buy the fucking bike. And then all of a sudden the guy's like, have you seen how light it is? Because it's all made out of carbon fiber and it's beautifully blue. And he gives it to me and he goes, put your fingers like this. I'm like, right? Like, what are we gonna do? And then all of a sudden he puts the bike on my fingers and it's so light. It was so light. I remember going like, holy shit, I need to buy this thing. Like, I've never seen a bike that's this light. This has to be something really special. So I'm like, dude, this is really cool. How much is it? And the guy just with a straight face, no worries in the world, goes, 80,000 euro. All of this, I had to control so that I could just go like this. Huh, that's not bad. But inside, I was fucking dying. 80,000 euro for a fucking bicycle? Are you kidding me? Does it suck your dick? Does it suck your dick backwards? Inside out, upside down. Like, what the fuck does it do? It's 80,000 euro for a bicycle. I can buy one at Target for like 200 bucks. Like, this makes no sense. So I go, no, you know what? To be honest with you, I'm not that much into bikes. I thought it was cool, but whatever. And he goes, ah, I see you're wearing a nice watch. And I think I was wearing either my Rolex or my AP, whatever the fuck it was at the time. And I go, yeah, I like watches. And he goes, well, we also have a watch. And I'm like, no way! How can someone be so stupid? How? You know what they're doing, Alejandro. Anyways, so he goes, here's the watch. And I look at it and I'm like, fuck, man, this is gorgeous. Like, gorgeous, gorgeous. How much is it? And it's like $750,000. And I remember just going like the same way, right? Like, that, you know what? It's not that nice. I'm not interested in the watch. I think I'm just gonna buy the car and just call it a day with that. And he goes, okay, I respect that, no problem. And by the way, at that time, I wanna get the fuck out of there because who likes to be in a place where people are just selling you shit all day long around you, like nonstop? No one, at least I think so. I think it sucks when there's like so much pressure to buy other shit. And then all of a sudden, the doorbell rings. I look at the door, they open the door and it's a Chinese kid. He walks in and he looks at me dead in the eye and goes, oh my God, I watch your YouTube channel. I go, no fucking way, this guy doesn't come to buy a Bugatti. He's like, oh my God, I watch your YouTube channel. Can we take a picture? We start taking pictures and all the Bugatti guys now are like, who the fuck is that Mexican guy and why do they want a picture with him? This makes no sense. But they liked it. They took it. They were like, this Mexican guy's gonna sell the car to this guy. Let's take him into the room right now while they're hot. So they bring us into the room. And this is where I'm getting really excited. I'm about to see the fucking car that I knew about for years that was gonna come out and it's gonna be epic. And there's a little tiny TV in front of us. And I remember thinking, right now Bugatti's about to show me something I've never seen in my fucking life. You're gonna click a button and then that wall's gonna turn around or it's gonna go up or it's gonna go down or it's gonna do something. And then the car's gonna be right there. Get ready for the moment of your life, Alejandro. All of a sudden, Winkleman walks in. With a remote in his hand, and I'm like, that's it, he's about to do it. Turns on the TV and he goes, ladies and gentlemen, I present you Devo. And I go, what? Who the fuck is Devo? Then the video starts playing and it's literally just the video and it's the Bugatti Devo. And I remember thinking to myself, oh my God, you're in here for not talking to your friend at the dealership and understanding what car he was talking about. You guys thought you were talking about the same car, but you were not. This is a different car. This is a fucking problem. I already raised $5 to $6 million to get the fucking car that I said. This is a new curve, like this is a curveball. So I'm sitting there and I'm like, maybe I'm wrong. Maybe this is the car and I'm not looking at it the right way. So I asked Stefan, I'm like, what's the difference between this and a regular Bugatti? And he goes, oh, you know, it's a little sportier, the suspension. And I go, so this is just like the special edition of Aventadors? And he goes, well, yes, but it's more special. It's like the Centenario. Oh. At that moment, I knew this motherfucker was gonna start doing the same thing he did with Lamborghini. I knew it.
My friend, Mr. Big Collector, this is the CEO of Lamborghini. How are you? We're creating our latest masterpiece. We are going to give you an Aventador Miura, and you're gonna love it, my friend, love it. And we can make it blue for you. What do you think? Lamborghini, my friend, Lamborghini.
I knew it. And immediately another problem came up to my head. And that problem was, I'm gonna have to buy 7 fucking Bugattis so I can buy the actual one that I want that's gonna be offered to me at the end of this. And I don't have the money for that. And now I'm gonna look fucking stupid in front of my friend that's giving me the money, and I'm gonna look stupid in front of my friend that owns the dealership. What am I gonna do? So whatever, I figure out like everything that they're doing. And I go, all right, this is what he's doing. He's 100% focusing on making this Bugatti thing like, you know, like the new Centenario, like he's gonna milk the shit out of these special edition cars. I knew it. So I leave and I remember calling my friend and I was like, dude, you're never gonna believe this. And he goes, what? I go, they showed me the wrong car. It was not the car that I thought. It's not the special edition this. And he goes, well, did you like it? And I'm like, yeah. And he goes, do you wanna still buy it? Do you think it's worth it? And that was like the hardest fucking thing in the world. I was like, nah, man, I don't think so. So we ended up not getting that fucking car. And of course now we know that that GT concept that I was looking for, it's called the Bollinger or some shit like that now. And it's gonna be super exclusive and like $12 million. So that's the car that I wanted. That is how I made an ass out of myself too. So everything just went wrong. And it was just one of those times where, oh man, it absolutely wasn't great being me that day. But, you know, I just went back to regular life and everything was pretty cool. But damn, am I stupid. Has that ever happened to you guys where you go to buy something, you get offered something, you want to get something, you're like, man, I'm so excited about this. And then last second they change it on you? Please let me know in the comments down below, because that is something horrible when you're doing whole sorts of fucking theatrics to get $5 to $6 million to get a car. So fucking believe it or not, that's what happened to me, and that's why they were trying to sell me the wrong Bugatti. Those motherfuckers. Anyways, that's the story I wanted to share with you guys, because I can't believe I haven't shared with you. Yeah, a lot of embarrassing moments in my life. Anyways, thank you very much for watching, guys. Take care and see you guys later. We'll be right back.